The waters around the Iranian island of Hormuz has mysteriously turned blood red. Many people have taken photos and videos and posted them to social media. One user wrote, "I can't believe it. Can it be trick photography?" Many others simply say, "Glory to God." The Strait of Hormuz flows between Saudi Arabia and Iran. This phenomenon could be due to pollution in the area or a result of red algae bloom. So far, the answer is not known. This comes at a mysterious time, when President Trump has recently threatened Iran for allegedly launching a missile near a U.S. embassy in Iraq, which has already been evacuated days prior. Saudi Arabia also alleges that Iran, or a proxy of Iran, attacked one of their ships. In recent months, plagues of locusts have invaded the Middle East, prompting many to speculate about biblical prophecy happening today.
Thank you. Nosso branco.
Thank you.
tenang. Tenang, tenang, tenang.
This video is going to be about Snapchat. Snapchat is a very serious app that many people just simply take it for granted. People just play with Snapchat and they think that this is something that is just a fun app. Sure, it may be fun. It may have this and it may have that. But the one thing that many people tend to ignore is that Snapchat, just like Facebook, is tied with the occult. Snapchat has many different filters. And I've mentioned this before to some people, but I never really brought it out to the public. I've said that there's something about Snapchat that when you examine Snapchat, Snapchat tends to pretend to actually get people to begin to have, because Snapchat has all these different filters where women look at these filters and then they make you have like glittery eyes. It makes you look like a cartoon. And it also makes you look like a human. A sexy animal, a sexy cat, a sexy dog. Snapchat is tied to the occult. And I know that there's going to be people who are going to be like, oh brother, come on. You mean we can't even use Snapchat now? You're going to demonize Snapchat for all of us? You're going to make Snapchat look evil? I'm not making Snapchat look evil. I'm simply just educating you on what you need to know. Number one, the main basic thing, I want you just to look at the symbol of Snapchat. Look at the symbol of Snapchat. What do you see? What does common sense tell you that you are seeing? Before you download this app, before you download Snapchat, if you search Snapchat, there's a certain icon, there's a certain symbol, there's a certain image. What is that image on Snapchat? That image on Snapchat is a ghost. Let's suppose that the symbol of Snapchat was a very scary looking ghost. Would you still download it? No, people would probably be like, oh, there's something about this app. Oh, I'm not sure. Ew, that thing's creepy. But you introduce a ghost that looks like a cartoon, a white silhouette, if you will. Now people all of a sudden, they begin to say, okay, you know what? This is something that we can go by. Be very careful. Deception comes in many different ways. Ladies and gentlemen, there's an app I mean, not an app, but there's a new filter that has recently been going viral. And this filter on Snapchat actually allows for transformation. It changes your appearance from being a man to a woman. And if you're a woman, it will change you from a woman to a man. What do you think that's going to do to people? When people begin to look at themselves as like a female version of themselves, they're going to start saying, wow, man, I look good. Oh, man, I look... The one thing that's common that I notice about these Snapchat filters, this Snapchat filter is it makes people actually look very good. And it makes them look really good as the opposite gender. And it gives them perfect skin, and it makes them look so, like, with nicely perfect skin. It makes them look good, and then eventually, people are going to start looking at this, and they're going to start saying, "Wow, man, I look good, man. I need to start." For the men, they're going to say, "You know what? Let me go and start. Let me get rid of all my beard, and let me start putting makeup here and putting makeup there." And eventually people are going to start going and actually beginning to want to mimic what they're seeing. These filters are actually helping you become even more vain. There's women, there's girls who would go and apply these filters, and then they'll be sharing their posters, their pictures on Instagram. And when you look at them on Instagram, you'd be like, wow, this girl looks so good. She's so fine. But then you see them in real life. It's like, wait, is that the same? No, that's not. That's a different person. It makes them have perfect skin and all that. Same thing with the man. And now this same filter can be able to now take an adult's face and turn their faces into a child. You need to think about, what are you entertaining yourself with? There's people who have caught ghosts on Snapchat where they're chatting, or they're not chatting, should I say. They're snapping themselves, right? They're snapping themselves on their phones, and out of nowhere, another entity begins to show up. And they can't see it with their own eyes, but guess who or what sees them? It's the Snapchat. The app sees these things and it recognizes them. The filters recognize the ghosts. And so the ghosts begin to entertain these people with their presence. And some people are foolish to actually interact with these ghosts and say, stick your tongue out. And they do so. You see, they're chatting. You're chatting with an entity while snapping. Now do you understand? Snapchat, you're snapping your chat with the ghost. That's why in the app it has a ghost.
Hi guys. May 21, 2019. Well, our fellow Americans are just not getting it. They're just not getting it. And, well, how many Americans throughout our country actually know about all of this flooding that is taking place? All of the flooding that has taken place in the last 2 months. How many know about all of the flash floods that occurred last year? They probably don't even know what is happening in their own country. So let's start with Arkansas. Haven't you heard this before?
But now, heavy rains is causing flooding in Gravette Street. Neighbors tell KNWA Baker Street is notorious for filling up with water because the drainage systems are not cleaned out enough. Karen Alley lives on Baker Street and says only two or three drains are located in that area. This sometimes causes her street to be undrivable.
When it floods, the trash cans tip over and the trash just drains back into there. So I've never seen anybody come out here and clean it.
Alley and another neighbor say the city told them the drainage is clogged.
Oh, wow. Oh, I'm sure they were happy to hear that. Didn't they know that? Do you know how many news reports with people in a whole lot of areas in a whole lot of states are saying exactly the same thing? Drainage. What's going on here? Cities, towns, they are just not keeping up with the drainage, and streets are flooding and homes are flooding, and Americans aren't getting that. This is deliberate. So Oklahoma, now it's Oklahoma, Iowa, Nebraska, Kansas, well, Texas, Illinois, now it's Oklahoma. Rescues. Massive flooding in Oklahoma. I mean, we're seeing this truly as the new normal now. This is our new normal. And people aren't questioning what the hell is going on. Look at Oklahoma.
the hurricane here. It's actually a subtropical cyclone. You can see it rotating here at the Himawari, and it's a very large, organized system. You can also see it over here at the GOES. See it right there. And there's also, believe it or not, which is kind of unusual for these types of storms, lightning associated with this storm system. In fact, quite a bit of lightning. The lightning has been climbing all day in North America. When I first looked at this morning, it was at around 8,000. Yesterday, it had peaked at around 45,000. Keep in mind, I've seen this up in the neighborhood of 80 and 90,000. So 40,000 is a very strong number, but I've seen it even stronger. This is a very strong storm that did produce a lot of tornadoes that went through the Midwest, and it's still pumping out moisture right now as I do this video. Flash flood warnings through Missouri, Illinois, tornado warnings. You can see the reds here. This is on the GOES 16. Those red areas in these respective counties are tornado warnings that are currently active right now as I do this video, and they've been trending like this all day long. The storm systems, the squall line is moving very, very quickly. Again, it's moving through eastern Missouri, west central Illinois, moving north northeast at a pretty good clip, around 30, 35 miles per hour. All of these green areas you see here with respect to counties, there's dozens and dozens of counties that are under flood warnings. What that represents, if you go down here and look at the legend down here, red is tornado, which I just showed you. The yellow squares and solid squares are severe thunderstorms. Pinks are snow, which we're still seeing snow. And flood, the green that we're seeing all over this map through the Great Plains, the Mississippi River Valley, that's flood warning. A tornado, I think it was an EF0. It's either a tornado or a very high profile dust devil. It's tall, or let me go back to it real quick. It was a very tall structure, and they're defining this, even at azfamily.com, as a tornado. Photo taken by Sean Williams. Great observation. Some unique clouds here, sent in by Mr. Variot. I think this is out of Australia. Chicago, my pet zombie, pinkish purple sky. Just beautiful. Good job, guys. Another one from Chicago, my pet zombie. You can see the moon up there amongst these orange clouds. Really unique sky here. It's got that line that we see like this right here. We've seen that off and on quite a bit the last, I don't know, couple of years around the globe. There's a double-decker roll cloud. Look at that. You don't see that very often. Rick from Wisconsin. Double-decker roll cloud. That was within the last 7 days. Good job, guys. Keep the photos coming. I do get to them sooner than later. Here's another slideshow of some pictures that I've got for you guys. In fact, I want to show you this fireball first. This was from Australia. This was sent in by, here we go, right here. Max Goldfield out of ABC Brisbane. You're going to see a green fireball. Look at that. That was on May 19th around midnight. Light up the sky. In fact, in this camera view here, turns night today. Look at that. Awesome fireball. May 19th in Australia, North Territory. Great observation. Thanks for sharing, guys. There's been a few here lately. Had one about a week ago that was a very, very high profile fireball that... In the Sky by Brenda from Ontario, Canada. And guys, we'll start covering, I'm going to stop it here real quick, we'll start covering more weather up in Canada. There's been a lot going on down here in the United States I've been trying to keep up with. But this photograph here is very interesting, and according to Thomas, this first bird was not in the sky when he took the photograph. The second one was, but the first one wasn't. So it's kind of like you're having a little fun with it, a ghost bird. But how did that happen, you know? He did not see that bird. He saw this one, but he didn't see that one. So, kind of a strange photograph. I've had that for a couple of weeks. I didn't really know what to do with it. So we'll just have a little fun with it. We've got a ghost bird flying in front of a bird. Sent in by Thomas. Costa Rica, Nicole. Big halo with what looks like a pterodactyl flying through the halo. Boston, Vanessa. Beautiful. I don't know if this is a sunrise or a sunset. Spectacular photograph. Jacob from New Orleans. Beautiful sky. Good.